Hello, this is Mandar Marathe. You're with me for Facebook advertising. In this video, we are going to talk about brand awareness campaigns on Facebook. As you are aware, you can market across the funnel, whether your target audience is at the awareness stage, consideration stage, or conversion stage. Facebook has different campaign objectives to help you achieve your business goal. At the awareness stage, you want your audience to know why your business exists. At the consideration stage, you want to capture their attention and help them arrive at a decision. At the conversion stage, you want them to become your customers, choosing your business over your competitors' businesses. When it comes to brand awareness, it is about wanting your audience to know that your business exists and being one of the first names that come to their mind when they think about a product or a service, which means you want to create top of the mind recall for your brand or for a specific product or service that you are offering. So what does it take to build brand awareness? There are four critical components of brand awareness. The first component is reach, which means how many people did your ad reach for every dollar that you spent. The second is frequency, which means how many times did they see your ad. The third is the communication or the quality of the message itself. Was your ad effective, persuasive, or could your target audience remember your communication? And finally, there might be other factors that are included for brand awareness. This includes perceived attributes for your brand or your current product adoption, or how are your competitors advertising in the same space? Essentially, how many people you reach, how many times they see your ad, what is the quality of the product or the quality of the communication, all affect your brand awareness. For achieving brand awareness as a business objective, we have different campaign objectives in Facebook. You can either select brand awareness or reach, and we'll discuss the difference between these two. Or you can select engagement to get more likes, shares, and comments. And finally, you can select video views if you're using video for building brand awareness. Let's look at these different campaign objectives and how they are different from one another. First of all, when it comes to brand awareness, you are optimizing your campaigns so that you reach people who are more likely to pay attention to your ad. A simple use case might be a fashion retailer who wants to raise awareness for one of his new collections. When it comes to reach, you want to maximize reach for a target audience, which means they might already know about your product or service, but you want to maximize the number of people who you are reaching. An use case would be a retail chain that has a weekend sale, and they would like to reach out to a group of shoppers and make them aware of this weekend sale. When it comes to video views, we want to reach people who are most likely to watch your video. Let's say a luxury brand, a watch or a car, right? They want their audience to be inspired by a great lifestyle video that they have created. When it comes to engagement, you want to reach people who are more likely to click, like, comment, or share. Essentially, engage with your ad. Now, when is this required? Let's say a travel company wants its audience to share their dream holiday destination. Essentially, you want to generate a lot of crowdsourced content, or you want your audience to be engaged with the content that you are creating. For each of these different campaign objectives, there are specific metrics that you can use to measure the performance of these campaigns. For brand awareness, we use estimated ad recall lift, and we are going to talk about ad recall lift soon. For reach, you will measure the number of impressions, and it is measured by CPM or cost per mille, which is the amount you're spending for showing 1,000 impressions of your ad. Videos, you use video views as the metric. And you optimize your campaigns, or you measure your campaigns based on how much you've spent for getting one video view, or what's the cost per view. When it comes to engagement, you're going to select or choose cost per click as the metric that you want to measure. Now, what is the target audience that you can select for building brand awareness? As you might know, there are three different types of audiences available on Facebook. You have your core audiences, which is your audiences on Facebook, and you can target them based on their demographic profile, their interests, their online behavior, where they are located, and how they are connected to your brand. Or you can target your audience based on how they have previously interacted with your brand. These are your custom audiences. So you can create brand awareness for your existing customers, or people who visited your website, or people who have engaged or visited your store offline, or engaged with your content on Facebook. If you select engagement as one of the custom audiences, then you can specifically reach out to people who have either engaged with your ad or engaged with the content that you post on your Facebook or Instagram page. When it comes to your ad engagement, you can essentially reach out to people who have spent time watching your videos, either on Facebook or Instagram, people who have engaged with your lead ads, again on Facebook or Instagram, or people who have engaged, clicked on your full screen experience or your canvas ads. When it comes to your page content, you can target people who have liked your page, or people who have interacted with your Instagram business profile, or people who have shown interests on the events that you have created on Facebook. You can also create a lookalike audience for each of the custom audience that you have. Let's say you have built a custom audience for all people who have seen one of your brand videos. Now you can create a lookalike audience for this profile and reach out to similar people who have a likelihood to pay attention to your video. What are the different creatives and placements? What are the different ad formats that you'll use for brand awareness related campaigns? You can either use the carousel ad format, or the single image ad format, the single video ad format, or a slideshow for building awareness. A carousel can be used to show variety of your products. You can use a single image ad to portray or delineate your brand visually. This can be a strong image with a great, attractive, intriguing copy. Or you can run video ads to increase engagement and get more people to watch videos. As you might know, videos is the type of content that people are consuming the most online today. Or you can simply use slideshows to create a sequence of looping images. Simply put, you need to just upload 10 different images, and you can build your own slideshow or GIF in Facebook itself. When it comes to using video, it is recommended that you use the square format, which is the 1:1 aspect ratio. By using this square format, it is possible that your video is played right or your video displays correctly, even if the phone is tilted by the user. What are some of the best practices for your creative ads? What are some of the best brand practices for your creatives? First and foremost, you should know your audience, which means you need to segment your audience and create or build different creative for each of your audience segments. You need to make sure that you're using eye-catching images and videos. Your creative stands out against the competition and the clutter that's there on Facebook or Instagram. Write compelling, intriguing ad copy to drive interest. And lastly, make sure that you're testing and experimenting with a variety of ad formats for building brand awareness. See which one works for you the best, whether it's a single image or a video or a carousel ad. What we have seen is that video ads perform really well when it comes to building brand awareness. How will you measure your brand campaigns? How will you understand what's working and how to improve your brand awareness campaigns? Like I stated earlier, brand awareness can be measured using a metric known as ad recall lift. Now, what is ad recall lift? It is the estimated number of people who are likely to remember your ad. Now, how do people remember your ad? It depends on three different metrics. First and foremost, the campaign reach, which means how much or how many people actually viewed your ad. Second is the time that they have spent on your ad. Right? What is the relative attention that they have given on your ad? Did they watch the entire video or they dropped off after watching a few seconds of the video? Did they spend 2 seconds or more on a single image ad, and so on? And finally, there is an historical ad recall metric. This is based on a Facebook study that they had created for 300 plus global brands to understand how Facebook ads impact reach and attention of users. So data from these global brand studies is taken into consideration while estimating the ad recall lift for your brand campaign. Let's look at how Angel Broking, which is an investment or a trading company, use brand awareness as a campaign objective to build or create impact on Facebook. So Angel Broking is one of India's leading brokerage house. It has a platform called as ARQ, A-R-Q, which is an intelligent automated investment engine. And previous to building brand awareness, So what was their solution for building brand awareness? They earlier used to run only conversion or lead generation ads on Facebook, and they did not have any brand awareness ads. They had used reach and frequency buying and essentially had replicated or duplicated their TV commercial and created a video that ran through RNF campaigns. The TVC was adopted for suiting the mobile environment, which means the video was converted to a 1:1 aspect ratio. They also added subtitles for a sound off viewing experience. As I had stated earlier, for most of the users on Facebook, videos play sound off. So if you're using a video in your ad, make sure that you have added subtitles for this viewing experience. ARC or Angel Broking also used carousel ads, which was a combination of several images that focused on different features of its product. The results that they achieved were phenomenal. They reached 9.2 million people and they acquired customers at a 70% lower rate than what they had done earlier. They saw twice the number of lead closures after running brand campaigns on Facebook. That's it for now. See you soon on another video with Facebook ads.